And we have to move to the next paper, which is prevalence of cardiovascular conditions among first trimester pregnant females in Anuradhapura district. The paper is from Hettiarachchi, Lokunarangudu, Agampodi, Jayasingha, Koralagedara, Varnasekara, Madhushika and Agampodi SB.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Dr. Ayesh Hettiarachchi from Department of Community Medicine, Rajarata. Prevalence of cardiovascular conditions among first trimester pregnant females in Anuradhapura district. Pregnancy should be a special and secure time in woman's life. Yet, every time woman goes through pregnancy, she risks losing her life. When we look into the global background, every day approximately 800 women die from preventable causes related to pregnancy and childbirth. Worldwide, this ending preventable maternal mortality still remains a global health priority. Cardiac disease is one of the most common indirect cause for maternal deaths worldwide, both in high and low middle income countries. Addressing this issue in countries like low middle income countries such as Sri Lanka, it is very much important because 99% of all these deaths occur in low and middle income countries. When we look into the Sri Lankan status, National Maternal Mortality Review in year 2016 shows a MMR of 33.8 with 112 maternal deaths. When we look into the Anuradhapura data, it's 38.9, which is above the national average. And year 2016, cardiac deaths accounted for 11 maternal deaths, which was seconded only to postpartum hemorrhage. Year 2015, it was the leading cause with 28 deaths. And the bitter truth, the cardiac disease complicated maternal pregnancies is a postmortem finding. So to prevent this cardiac disease caused maternal death, we should have a better understanding of actual disease burden, how to identify it early, and what are the risk factors. For that, we developed a study. We evaluated a cohort of pregnant women in Anuradhapura for a better estimation of disease burden of heart disease and the cardiac disease risk factors in pregnancy. So we evaluated this cohort through the history, examination, and we referred them for 2D echocardiogram. This is our cohort. This cohort was conducted in all over the Anuradhapura district, to all the 22 MOH areas, starting from July 2019. We set a set of referral criteria by history and by the examination, and we referred them to the 2D echocardiogram with low threshold to the professorial teaching unit Anuradhapura and professorial unit teaching hospital Anuradhapura, and with the help of consult cardiologist, we perform echocardiogram with the latest echocardiogram machine with facilities of transesophageal echocardiogram. Total number of 2,895 pregnant females were recruited for the study. Mean age of the sample was 28.05. According to the history and symptoms and signs, these are the numbers we referred patients to the echocardiogram. So the echocardiogram we conducted 317 participants, found 5 mild PHTs, grade 1, 2 MR in 6 patients, grade 2 diastolic dysfunction in 9, and intra-atrial septal defects in 10. And interestingly, we found 1 dextrocardia. The interesting fact was she was detected at her 3rd pregnancy. So we missed dextrocardia for her last 2 pregnancies. So how significant our findings are? According to the morbidity data reported in 2019 in Anuradhapura district, there were 44 heart disease complicating pregnancies out of 13,376 mothers. So if we calculate the period prevalence, it was 0.3. But with our findings, there are 30 significant heart conditions. So when we adjust it to non-participation, it's 46.8 out of our 2,895 sample. So the prevalence is 1.61, which is more than 5-fold increase to the actually reported data. So we need to improve our screening facilities to detect early this maternal heart disease and its complications. So for that, now we are developing statistical models to develop guidelines for referral and screening of maternal patients. Conclusion, the cardiac disease complicating pregnancy identified was significantly higher than the routinely reported data. Current screening and heart disease may require change to increase the detection of these conditions. Thank you.
Okay, thank you for sticking to the time, and paper is open for discussion.
Actually, madam, as I said, that we are now developing, we are trying statistical modeling for this to develop referral criteria for the ground level people, that I mean the MOHs and the public health midwives. So we are still working on that, and we will suggest few recommendations to use at the ground level. Actually, what we did is we used high quality equipments, madam. We used cardiology 2 stethoscope for auscultation, and we used accurate blood pressure monitors. So that's what we did, and we referred them to 2D echocardiogram with low threshold.
Okay, so thank you.
Quick comment, excellent slides and very nice data presentation. Would you recommend, by your present findings, would you recommend a low threshold of cardiac referral from this basic screening before all the models have been done? But with your present findings, what can you do with that to detect and
yes, ma'am, actually, that if we use at least a good quality stethoscope, that would be enough to detect a heart murmur, because when we are doing the study, we compared whether these patients are detected to the routine system, but some of the patients were not. So for the moment, I would say that using the better equipment would be enough for at this point.
Thank you.
Okay, right. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.